Hi everyone! So, kakatapos lang namin magluto. Tingnan nyo, malinis na. Nagluto kami ng dal, batsak, and rotli. I will show you kung ano yung mga sinasabi kong dal, batsak, and rotli para hindi kayo nalilito. Ito yung chapati or rotli na sinasabi nila. Made out of flour, tapos may oil and water. This one is dal. This is the dal that they're saying they're making every day. But in dito sa bahay namin, araw-araw kaming gumagawa ng dal kasi gustong-gusto ko tong dal. Ginagawa ko siyang sabaw. Pinampapares nila ito sa kanin. Ang daming combination nito. Merong yung dal, tapos meron siyang asin, asukal, adu, tapos meron siyang lemon, at saka yung iba't ibang masala nila. Ito naman yung pataka at saka okra. Potato and okra. Tapos binigyan lang nila ng mga masala. Tapos, yung pinangpapares nila sa kanin, ito, yung dal. Yung pinangpapares nila sa rotli, ito namang sack na to, yung vegetables. Ayun, tapos kakain sila ng chas. Tapos, usually, every morning, gumagawa kami ng chas. Alam niyo yung alam niyo yung panis na gatas. Yung ilalagay nila sa isang container, ito yung sinasabi ko. Wait, papakita ko. Ito yung panis na gatas. So, itong gatas na to sa umaga, bibigyan namin siya. Bibigyan namin ng laman to ng gatas. Tapos, isi-set aside namin hanggang kinabukasan. Tapos, yung panis na gatas na to, yun yung gagawin nilang chas. Ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyong chas. Ayan, guys. Ayan ang sinasabi kong chas sa inyo. Tapos yan yung iinumin namin mamaya. Mamayang kakain kami, papakita ko kung paano siya. Tapos na rin lahat ng trabaho. Like, nagising kami ni Milan ng 6 o'clock. Araw-araw, sasanayin namin magising ng 6 o'clock. Tapos, naglalakad-lakad kami dun sa farm side. Kasi mas magandang... Parang mas maganda yung bungad ng araw mo kapag maaga kang nagigising. Alam mo yung nagiging productive ka everyday. Tapos, after 30 minutes or 1 hour of walking, babalik kami para gumawa ng siya kasi by that time, gising na sila yung mga tao sa bahay. So, bago kami umalis ni Milan, pupunta dun sa farm side. Magpapainit muna kami ng tubig para kapag pagka-uwi namin, mainit na yung tubig, di ba? Makakaligo na kami. Tapos, maumpisahan na namin yung araw namin. So, by around 7, nakaligo na ako. Tapos, mag-uumpisa na akong maglinis-linis ng mga cabinets. Tapos, after maglinis ng cabinet, magagawa na ako ng pagkain. So, ngayon, natapos kami gumawa ng pagkain ng 8:45. So, imagine, 8:45, mga around 9, free ka na. 9 o'clock to... Tapos, hihintayin mo na lang yung hapon, around 11:30, 12, kakain ka. Afternoon, 12 to 1, magkukwentuhan kayo, maghugas ka ng plato, kasi by that time, wala na si Sonal Masi. So, ako talaga ang naghuhugas ng plato, kasi parang yung kinain mo, mabawasan na rin, diba? Like, bumaba na rin. Tapos, after that, minsan natutulog ako, minsan hindi. Pero usually, nag-e-edit ako. Tapos, around 2:30, nakakatulog ako. Tapos, around 3, 4 o'clock, gagawa na naman nun siya. Tapos, after 4 o'clock, after nun siya, upo-upo. Tapos, minsan maglalampaso kapag medyo marumi. Kapag hindi marumi, upo-upo lang, manunood. After that, maglalakad-lakad ng 6 kilometers para medyo pumayat pa yan. Tumaba na naman ako. Hindi ko alam. Hindi ko alam kung bakit. Pero I think mamaya, yayayain ko si Milan kumain ng baraf. Alam niyo yung baraf na yung parang yellow siya, tapos mayroong flavor. Kayain ko siya mamaya. Kung kakakain kami ng ganun. Nagustuhan ko yung pagkain na yun kasi mainit. Mainit ngayon. Tsaka ngayon, naka-close door na kami. Kasi kapag hindi mo sinarayan, guys, ang init-init, mas mainit kesa sa Pilipinas. So, around, ngayon, magte-10 o'clock na. So, nakasara na lahat ng mga binto, pintuan namin para mapanatili yung lamig ng bahay namin. Kasi itong bahay na to, luma na to. So, nirenovate na lang nila ng konti kasi may balak silang magpagawa ng bagong bahay. I don't know when, but may balak sila kasi itong bahay na to, generation pa to ng grandfather ni Milan. So, it's been around like 60, 70 years. Tapos nirenovate lang para maging comfortable ang pamumuhay dito. But sa generation ni Milan, kailangan namin mag-build ng bahay talaga. So, hindi na kami gumagawa ng mga alterations pa dito kasi gagawa na lang kami ng bagong bahay. And yung bahay kasi ni Milan, pahaba siya, pahaba, hindi siya palapad. So, medyo makipot, pero comfortable na, malaki na siya kasi mayroon siyang tatlong floor, third floor. So, marami siyang kwarto. And hindi ko alam kung makakapag-house tour ako. I'll try to do house tour sometime. Ayan lang, guys. So, ang gagawin ko niyan. Siguro, upo lang ako dun sa sala. Tapos, Facebook, Instagram. I will try to edit. Mag-e-edit ako. And, ayun. Hintayin ko yung afternoon para kumain tsaka matulog. Hopefully, by June, mag-iba yung routine namin. Kasi may mga inaabangan kasi kaming mga results. So, by June, sana mag-iba yung routine namin. Hindi muna ako mag-disclose ng kahit ano, guys. You stay tuned to our channel para malaman niyo what will be the next step dito sa Filipino-Indian relationship namin. For now, we just have to enjoy the moment with our mother and father-in-law. And let's try to learn their culture and pakisamahan muna natin sila ng maayos, diba? I'm enjoying in here. They're very, very kind and very, very good people. So, I don't have any problem.
Nakain kami ngayon ng baraf. Si Milan Bayayo magpakuha. Ayan ha, arte-arte.
Okay, so every day, 10 rupees. Green mango.
Green mango.
Sobrang init na ngayon sa India, kaya perfect na perfect to. Kapag naiinitan ka na, kumuha ng 10 rupees. Around how many peso? 8? 7 peso? Oh, meron ka ng ganito. Sarap. Magpayo kayo ng ganito sa Pilipinas, guys. Tapos ibenta nyo nyo ng 20. O kaya 15.
What?
O kaya 10. Yellow lang siya, tapos meron lang siyang flavor. I told them to make a business like this in the Philippines. In competition to halo-halo. You know the halo-halo? This is cheap but very tasty. Very, very good for hot weather.
In Philippines, there is no hot weather.
How do you know? You've been in the Philippines and you don't know?
It's not hot as India. That's why.
Sarap yan. Kakain mo na kami, guys. Bye-bye.
Hi, everyone. So, currently, we are in this farm. There's Mommy and Milan. Because we are gonna estimate the mangoes in here. There's too many merchants already na pumupunta sa bahay namin. So, they are asking for a deal. Like, oh, let me handle your mango farm. Let me do your mango farm. These, I will give you this amount for this certain farm. We have 3 farms na kailangan naming i-close deal. So, currently they're estimating how much. Kumain kami ng baraf. Kaya, ganito yung lobby ko, guys. Pasensya na. Ayan sila. They're currently estimating per mango. Tignan niyo kung paano mag-estimate si mother-in-law. Galing-galing. Since they're doing it for like 20 plus years now. So, they are very expert when it comes to mango estimation. Tingnan nyo, guys. Titingala lang siya. Satman. 7 months. Bale, 20 kilos times 7. Oh. Dasman daw. 10. 10 times 20. 200 kilo. Yun yung mapupuno. 200 kilo. This mango. This mango will produce 200 kilo. Yun ang sabi niya. Tignan natin tong isa. Galing, no? Titingin lang siya, tapos gaganyan-ganyan lang siya, oh. Ganyan-ganyan lang siya. Astrology. Ayan, galing, di ba, guys? Hindi natin alam yan. Kahapon, merong pumuntang isang merchant. Bale, 2 beses siyang pumunta. Kasama niya yung buong angkan niya. Tinatry talaga nalang i-close yung 3 deal ng farm namin. So, isa tong farm na to, so tinatry nilang i-close. May isa kasing merchant na may utang pa sa amin. Yung isang merchant na yun, hindi niya binayaran yung mga natitira pa. Kailangan namin magbigay ng isang farm dun sa isang merchant na yun na may utang pa sa amin para ma-recover namin yung utang niya. So, kailangan niyang pagtrabahuhan. Pero, 3 pa rin yung kinu-close deal. Pag mas mataas yung binigay na presyo ng ibang merchant, dun kami sa mas mataas ang presyo, diba? Sino ba naman ang gustong mas maliit ang makuhang pera? So, ayun. May estimated amount na kami kung magkano namin ibibigay yung mga farm. Pero, tignan natin kung tatawad pa talaga yung mga merchants. Kasi, syempre, kailangan din nilang kumita, diba? Hindi na sila babalik sa amin pag hindi na sila kumita.
So, look at Dr. Sahib. Milan, show them your notebook.
I still didn't write anything. Huh? Pandar.
And this is 15. 15 times 20 kilo. 1 month is equals to 20 kilo, guys. So, usually, ang wholesale price, depende sa variety. 1,000 to 1,400 per 20 kilo. Yun ang binibigay nila as a wholesaler. Pero, sa merchant ha, tapos yung merchant na yung bahalang magpatong ng presyo niya at mag-distribute sa market.
How much, Milan?
Sitter.
What is sitter?
70.
70 mon times 20, how much? 1,400 kilos.
In this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12 mango trees.
For 12 mango trees, it's 1,000 plus kilo.
1,400
kilo in 12 mangoes. So, i-times nyo yun sa 1,000 to 1,400, guys. Yun ang kita ng 12 mangoes. Ha? Ayan. Ito naman ang nila. I-estimate nila. Ayan, guys. Nakikita nyo. Milan, when is the harvest? Oh, Milan. Harvest, kiyare? Oh, guys. Ayan. Maliliit pa lang sila. Pero may mga merchants na nga na nanghihingi ng rate. See. Iba-ibang variety. Hindi ko alam kung swerte ba yung year na to. Kesar. This is Kesar. Ah, Kesar daw, guys. Most famous variety of Gujarat. Do you think this
variety in the world is Alfonso?
Alfonso kay Chi Alfonso.
That's the last biggest tree is Alfonso.
I do not.
But in Gujarat, most famous is Kesar. So we have one Kesar and Amrapali.
This is my first mango season. So they are joking around if I will be very lucky. Like if I'm bringing them luck or kamalasan. So let's see if this season will be very good for them, for us. They are joking that, there's no mango this year because Elaine came in our family. So let's see if they manage to be lucky. I will tease them. If they did not get that much, they will tease me for sure. To avoid costing unnecessary cost, they always bring water. Just going to the market, they will bring water. Just going to the city, they will bring water. They always manage to remove all the unnecessary cost. So I salute this Indian family.
my Indian family for that because they really buy the necessary thing. They make sense, right? Why will you buy water outside? Well, you can buy water outside if you're not bringing it. But if you're bringing it, you can save, if you're four people, you can save around 60 rupees, right? Good thing. Very, 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 very hosiar. Very, very smart people. Guys, this is Alfonso. Ayan, no? Very big tree, no, Milan? Very here's big. Alfonso. How many varieties do you have in this farm?
10, 15
varieties. Which one is the costliest?
Queso.
Queso. Bull. Ayan, guys. This is the famous. Famous in the whole India. Alfonso. Ilang beses na rin kaming... Grabe, pawisan na ako. Ilang beses na rin kaming pabalik-balik para mag-estimate ng mga mangga. Kahapon, hindi ako nakapag-video, pero nag-estimate din kami ng mga mangga. Yung sa isang farm. So, ito na yung last na i-estimate nila. Mamaya sasabihin ko sa inyo kung ano yung estimated total nila. Sorry guys, nakaka-bother talaga yung lips ko. Kumain kasi kami nung ano, nung green, yung sa unang video, unang part ng video na to, yung green na baraf. Ayun.
What did you say?
Instead of shooting video, try to learn.
I am learning. You okay, okay. Again, this
you
one.
You will be doing this.
Milan, naibol, mami naibolwano, ha? May estimate.
Kina-guess karwa de uti.
Awad yun, ha?
Guess.
At. Nay? Kailano?
Punchman.
Kaina, it's better to have higher
shut
one.
Up. Nobody will come to your mango farm if you keep guessing wrong.
At be. Jo, make it to be. At.
Ah, shut up. Shut up.
I said what? This to at.
No.
Correct, she.
No.
Awajo. Again. Naibol one, mami, ha? Wait. Add this one. Thus. Thus, man. Who? Thus, man, Jo. What can you say? What can you say?
About this one.
Thus, man, thus,
this
man.
This one.
I am right with this one,
yes,
guys.
This one.
Aba, ja, bow badare.
Can they even see it?
Yes, too many, huh?
Oh.
This one is bar. Bar na eh, mami? Barabar che jo, bar. Complete at che, Milan. Hukido? Bar. Ete? Bar. Jo, I'm ready, guys. I'm ready to do the estimate. Abar che, barabar. Jo bar, barman.
Because it's easy to guess. It's small mango and
there
you can see a lot of mango already.
Yes, as I said, barman. Too many guys, huh? Too many already.
Then I will
tell you. Too many mangoes already. Can you guys see it? Milan? How much is the total?
Very less.
How many? How many, man? I cannot see. Total.
Total, we didn't do total yet.
Okay. I will tell you the total of this farm, guys.
But
the
this
one
is
with
very
farm
least mango farm. Mm. Other two did good than this.
Mm-hmm. Very little, no?
Mm-hmm.
This is the farm with farmhouse. We'll tell you later how many. Nangunguha si mother-in-law ng kamatsili. Ayan. Kumat chili, guys. Ang simple ng buhay, no? Sige, guys. Kaya mo yan. Ayun, nakuha niya. Go, mommy! Salome, my dad. Kamatsili.
Gusto mo kamatsili?
Oo, gusto ko. Alam mo pala mag-Tagalog ah. Marunong ka pala mag-Tagalog.
Nakauwi na kami. How much Milan total?
565
man times 20 kilos. How much? So there will be 11,300 kilos of mango in that farmhouse, mango farm.
Hoy! Mag-subscribe ka? Pakpuro nood!